Like many Microsoft errors, the OLE action error is annoyingly persistent when the issue goes unresolved. But the good news is the cause of your frustration is normally a simple fix once you determine where to look. OLE, which stands for Object Linking and Embedding, is a feature that allows various applications to share data, like objects, links, workbooks, and charts. But when you see this error pop up on your screen, Microsoft is telling you that the transfer of data is taking too long. You might get the Excel OLE error when trying to send a workbook through Outlook, or it may appear intermittently because of some hidden links or outdated software. But in my experience, the most common culprits of an OLE action error are either conflicting Excel add-ins, a disabled DDE protocol, or a compatibility mode issue. However, your situation may lead to none of these. So let me show you all the troubleshooting techniques I use to narrow down the cause and fix the problem for good. The first thing you should do is close out all your programs and restart your computer. Sometimes all that's needed is to clear out any pending transfers between applications and start fresh. This may solve nothing, but it's a quick box to check off your list. If that didn't work, I'd then disable the DDE feature for my workbook. DDE, or Dynamic Data Exchange, is what activates the OLE between programs. So by disabling it, we could bypass the error altogether. To do this, open the Options menu under the File tab and select Advanced. In the General section, find the box for Ignore Other Applications That Use Dynamic Data Exchange, DDE. Click OK and restart Excel. The third troubleshooting trick you should try is to disable your Excel add-ins. While add-ins can boost your productivity, not all add-ins are created equal. Your favorite Excel add-in may function perfectly in Excel, but that doesn't mean it's compatible with the other installed add-ins. So I recommend disabling all add-ins, but you could turn them off one by one to find the root cause. To test this out, open the Developer tab of your ribbon and select Excel Add-ins. From here, check off the boxes and click OK. After they're disabled, restart Excel and see if it worked. Now, if you don't see the Developer tab, you'll have to add it under the Options menu and Customize Ribbon section. Then follow the previous steps, or simply open the File options again and select Add-ins. Next up, let's disable Compatibility Mode. This doesn't always have an effect, but many users have sworn by its success. First, you'll have to find the Excel executable, which is the source Excel application, not the specific document you're working with. Its location varies between computers, but you can often find it in the Microsoft Windows subfolders. The file itself will have a .exe extension. When you find it, right-click and select Properties. Under the Compatibility tab, uncheck the box for Compatibility Mode and hit OK to disable it. Now reopen your original file and test the results. This next method to try is for those who are experiencing the Excel OLE action error when trying to email a workbook from within Excel. Specifically, if you're in Excel and choose to share via email from the File tab, the data transfer between Excel and Outlook might be the source of your headache. Instead, I'd recommend opening your email and then attaching the workbook from its file path. It's often an effective way to get around your delayed action error. Another reason for this error might be found in the links embedded in the file. They may be corrupted or contain inaccurate references Microsoft can't overcome. Normally, you can inspect the links by opening the Data tab on your ribbon and click the Edit Links button. However, if no links are identified, the button is grayed out. But that doesn't mean there aren't hidden links causing an issue. If you've gone this far and still haven't solved the OLE problem, I'd suggest checking the Name Manager for external links, or using the GoTo Special feature to locate any links embedded into objects within the file. You could also choose from several different Excel add-ins that are well equipped at handling hidden and broken links. If you're still stuck and none of these methods have worked, there are a few more options. I'd recommend checking for any new Microsoft updates, as the error may go away with the latest bug fixes. You could also consider reinstalling your Microsoft applications if you feel comfortable with it. Just be sure to back up any important data first. Finally, you can run the Office Repair tool in hopes of fixing the problem. It's an easy process and one that I discuss in this next video while troubleshooting another popular Excel error.